Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for iOS Today is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
Coming up, can an app replace your guitar teacher?
Plus, I have a Superfly video editor.
And use your iPhone and your iPad to travel more safely.
All that and more coming up on iOS Today. iOS Today is brought to you by Gazelle, the online marketplace for buying and selling used gadgets. Shop from a variety of certified pre-owned electronics or trade one in for cash. Give new life to a used device. Visit gazelle.com today. And by the Ring Video Doorbell. With Ring, you can see and talk to anyone at your door from anywhere in the world using your smartphone. It's like caller ID for your home. Right now, get free FedEx shipping when you go to ring.com/iOS today. And by Texture, the mobile app that lets you access the world's most popular magazines anytime, anywhere, using your phone or tablet. For your free 30-day trial, visit texture.com/iOS. Yeah! Yeah!
We're back.
Welcome to iOS Today. Leo Laporte.
Megan Maroney.
And this is the show I've been waiting for. We were going to do it last week, but then the Apple TV came out and I had to spend hours setting it up for you. We did edit that down, didn't we?
We edited it a little bit down, but you could still feel our pain,
I think. You could feel the frustration. So, I just want to report an update on that.
Okay.
Because I've now installed two more Apple TVs for a total of four. One for you, and three at my house, because we liked it so much. And the issue was pairing your smartphone, your iPhone, or I guess it would work with the iPad, to the Apple TV. We had a devil of a time until we rebooted your phone, and that seemed to fix it. So I've tried it again twice more, and the bump, they call it what Apple's calling it, the bump, where you tap your phone. It's not NFC, but you tap your phone or get it really close to the Apple TV, and the Bluetooth sees it. It's short-range Bluetooth. It worked flawlessly both times. So I think whatever it was something on your phone was blocking it. It's a great tip, reboot your phone if it's not working, but my experience now has been that it's pretty reliable. I'm really loving this Apple TV.
I really love it, too. And, of course, on MacBreak Weekly, you guys talked about it, and Serenity had amazing tips for using the remote. Because I was having a lot of trouble just going, especially entering your password, going back and forth on that keyboard, going from caps to no caps, and you hold the play button, tap the play button to go back and forth between caps and lowercase, as opposed to going all the way down to the lowercase and all the way.
Who knew?
Yeah, so using the size, we've had
There's
a great
lot
time.
Of stuff. And Serenity's best tip was, and I don't know, maybe Apple shows you somewhere, but there's an online manual that's complete and has lots of great information. If you just got an Apple TV, you should absolutely go online and look at the online Apple TV menu. That's where most of those tips come from. But I'm impressed. I really feel like the quality of the image is great. It's easy to navigate. I love telling Siri, jump back 2 minutes, jump ahead 2 minutes. What did she say? I've used that a few times. It's a really nicely done. I wish Amazon would I feel like Amazon's going backwards. Not only they're refusing to sell the Apple TV or anything that doesn't have Amazon streaming on it, but it seems that there's Amazon streaming is getting in fewer and fewer places. I can't do it on Android. I can't do it on iOS. I used to buy a lot of stuff on Amazon. Because I figured, I'll be able to play that everywhere. And now it's increasingly not the case. It's much like Apple, where you have to have an Apple TV to watch iTunes stuff. You have to have an Amazon Fire TV, in many cases, to watch Amazon stuff.
Well, you can AirPlay it, but that's not easy.
I don't think that's a good choice, frankly. So I'm thinking that the reasons not to get an Apple TV are dwindling. If they put an Amazon app, if they let an Amazon app on there, it would be the choice. You know, I just read an article today in Quartz, which is a really great publication. A fellow reviewed, he says, every one of them, everything. And he spent a long time with it. And his pick, bar none, is the Apple TV.
For iOS users, he said.
No.
Really?
No, for your TV. So he reviewed the Android. There it is. The ultimate 10,000 word review, Apple TV versus Roku versus Fire TV versus Chromecast. He refused to review the Google TV device, the Nexus TV, and he refused to review the one I actually quite like, which is the NVIDIA Shield Android TV device. He said they're not good enough to even put in this review. Still got 10,000 words, but he did pick Apple TV.
Even if you're on Android, if you have an Android phone?
Yeah. Or, just in general. Just don't even worry about it. Yeah, it works. I mean, it's not the phone that's really the critical part of this. Admittedly, setup is harder if you don't have an iOS device. But who watches iOS today and doesn't have an iOS device?
That's true.
Not me.
No, not, yeah.
Not you.
Exactly. So we're going to talk about music today. We have music apps. You know, you said you just got the new Beatles One Plus album. You love music.
Love music.
But you don't, you've
I
never
can't play
made
it.
I can't play
it's
it
frustrating
either.
Frustrating to me.
I can't play it either.
You know where this came from? The last week or the week before, I was doing Guitar Hero. The new Guitar Hero had just come out. And I said, it's really a shame because people spend hours getting mastering Guitar Hero. I was at my son's apartment. They have two Guitar Hero guitars. And if they spent half that time trying to play a real guitar, they could play a guitar. It turns out there are ways to not only have fun, but learn to play a guitar.
Right. So are we ready to start with you? Musician is the first app. And
all right.
They have a free version of Musician.
I'm worried. I see a guitar
behind
me.
You're going to play it. And Anthony has the membership to Musician. I think it's $100 a year.
Oh, it's expensive. Now, Anthony, this is Anthony's guitar, and he's a real guitar player.
I thought this also would be good because some people might.
It's a hobby.
Okay. That's all I want. I want to be able to sit down next time I'm at my son's frat and play I Gave My Love a Cherry That Had No Stone.
Okay.
I think it'd go over great.
All right, well, let's see. Can you...
What,
you
wanna... mean I have to do it now?
Yeah.
Do I have to get up to do this?
You have to stand up on your feet.
Get
and
up,
hold
stand
the guitar.
Up.
Do you know how to hold a guitar?
No, but Anthony's going to show me. All right, so let me go over here. Hold on. I don't, you know, I have a lot of wires connected to me right now.
I didn't know that I was going to do that in the dress rehearsal.
Yeah, well.
There. Oh, yeah, next you don't have to stand up. You can
next
sit.
Time we'll
folk,
do a dress
you
rehearsal.
You wanted to do folk singer
Well, no,
style.
Now I understand why Burke was asking for slack. I thought he just wanted me to cut him some slack. All right, wait a minute. Oh, there's a thing here. What is this?
So that you connect your phone or your iPad to the guitar.
Okay.
And so it can hear what you're playing.
Okay, and then I pick up the guitar.
Yes.
And I put it on, and then that's all I have to do, right?
And then suddenly you're... Okay, Anthony might have to help
you
walk.
No, I got it.
Okay, okay.
All right, I was just being silly.
Oh, that sounds beautiful.
All right, it's got a little fuzz tone on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I could play one song.
Okay. Oh, you can?
Yeah.
Wait. I
learned this when I was 8. Drill ye terriers, drill. Drill ye... Oh, there's a pick. Wow.
So
I have to hold the pick now.
Someone
this
in the
is
chat
getting
room
more
is
complicated.
Saying that you're left-handed, so you are playing
this
right-handed.
This is tuned properly.
Yes.
No. This is exactly how I would play it.
Oh.
You restrung it.
Yeah, I tuned it up.
For a lefty?
No. It's not, actually.
Okay.
Maybe.
That's my excuse. I'm a lefty.
Okay.
Now, what do I do? So this is $100 a year.
Well,
should I press start here?
That's more like an intro.
Strings and frets.
Let's go back.
I should learn back to... Oh, they call them missions, which is, I think, a good idea. So what mission should I do?
One of the early ones, so...
One of the very early ones.
One or two. So maybe back up to... let's try strings and frets.
That's what I was thinking as well. Trainer, picking strings. Play the string on the diagram. It's like looking at the strings. So, yeah, we should start pretty early, because even though I'm an expert...
So this is...
The second...
The bottom is closest to you.
Right.
So the top is
all right, third thickest string. So it actually knows what I'm playing.
Yep.
It can hear.
Whoops. Third thickest string. That's not how I usually think of it, but. So you're learning the little E is the thinnest string. You're learning the notes and the strings. This is obviously not ideal. Oh, it's using the microphone on the iPhone to pick it up.
Actually,
that's kind of cool.
Third
thinnest string. 1, 2, 3. All right, I'm getting good at picking too, don't you think? I could be like Johnny Cash. Little E. Big E is the thickest string. Second thickest string.
Well done. You can continue to the next exercise.
Thank you, Jimmy. Okay, let's try the next exercise. It's open all night. Play when the ball lands on the note. So this is kind of similar to playing Guitar Hero,
but
except you're doing a real guitar, right? The zero means to play it open. Part one uses the thickest string closest to you, and part two adds in the second thickest string. I like the terminology. What?
So that's the closest
one. This is all a Guitar Hero. But I have to play a real guitar, which I think is great. This was my whole point, is if you spent the time, at this point it's very easy, much like Guitar Hero, if you spent the time doing this on a real guitar, oops. What? Oh, it's the second. Oh. Wish I could use my fingers. They're really tough. The grading curve is difficult here. All right, I get the idea. This is great,
Let's
though.
Let's give it another try, shall we?
How far down the road have you gone with this, Anthony? Hey.
So I've got 2 bars. I can see how it would be very helpful for someone who's just
Yeah, well, you can see I know nothing. Yeah. But what it's teaching me is initially where the strings are, a little bit about picking. Eventually, we're going to get the rhythm. But what's fun is it's gamified.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a fun thing to do. That's cool. What's that called again?
It's musician.
Musician.
So, musician.
Use it.
You.
Like you. Me. You. I'm the musician.
And I think I might have gotten that pricing wrong. I said $100 a year, but maybe there's different pricing. There is a free version.
Anthony said $100
a year.
Play for free?
But you can only do so many lessons.
Right.
And
that's good.
Features that are unlocked when you...
You should try it before you buy it. So I think play for free for the
definitely.
First few lessons is a great idea. You know what? That is as fun as... Guitar Hero, yeah. I think. Does it get that? I mean, does it get more fun? There are other Guitar Hero-like games that you do actually use a real guitar as opposed to a specially designed Guitar Hero guitar. Thank you, John. That's cool.
So, you know, Lisa had took some, your wife Lisa, she took some guitar lessons when she was young. So, if you're looking for
a gift, give her a guitar and a ticket to Tucson. Where is it? El Paso. Yeah.
All right.
That's cool.
So, musician.
And you can find out more at get.yousician.com. And do they have it for, it's just iOS, huh? Do they have it
Android
for Android too?
Well.
All right.
So here's another one that I took a look at.
I like the philosophy they said. We're all born musical.
We are. Another one that is free is Real Guitar.
Oh, look at that. That looks like a real guitar.
And if you're going to... You know, maybe you don't want to just buy a guitar for someone for the holidays. It's expensive, so you want to see if they're really... So this is, they've recorded an acoustic guitar, and this is the sound. So you can play around with this. Again, I have no musical training whatsoever beyond second-grade piano. I know. So
I like the sound on that. It's quite good.
Different picks.
So you don't even need a guitar for this.
No, you don't.
But truthfully, this isn't going to really put you in the right direction.
No, it's going to do a few...
Because, I mean, I don't think you could go from that to playing a guitar. Do you think you could? Maybe you could.
No, I don't think so. But there's tabs in here. There's a lot of songs that you can play. But something to try out, and it has ads. So if you want to start small and see if you want to just play around a little bit, that's real.
I don't have a choice. A start small is my middle name, frankly.
Well, I brought Anthony's guitar home and tried to use that app, and I didn't have the interest was the problem.
Have you ever played with any of the Smule
apps? I have.
There's an Apple TV version of one of them.
Yes, of the karaoke,
which is a great idea.
Yes. So, yeah, you want to take a look at Magic Piano by Smule?
Yeah.
Smule
This is actually one of the very first iPad apps ever. Smule's been around a really long time.
Magic Piano is what you would like to... Simply Piano. Is that Smule? No, that's Joy.
No, Smule's is Magic Piano, I think. Okay. And they also have, as you mentioned, Sing Karaoke, which is iOS, but also Apple TV.
Right.
And that would be really fun, I think, for the whole family. And they do a guitar one as well. But Smule is more about kind of collaborative playing with other people over the internet than it is about learning an instrument.
Okay, so here is Smule. There's the grand... Where are we? Level... So this is more gamifying it.
Yeah, and it's also about playing with other people on the internet. I really like Smule. I think they're a great company. They did I think they did an Ocarina. They've done some really interesting apps, some of which are gone.
So it's more of a game. Let's play the medium.
Okay.
Here's the Magic Piano. Three fingers together. Okay. Start. Can you hear that? So I'm just supposed to play it when they come. I'm getting...
Yeah, that's awesome.
And then I can play with more than one finger eventually. I'll have to play slower. Were you forced to take piano lessons when you were young?
No, I was forced to take guitar lessons, and you can see where it got me.
So, Smuel, magic piano.
Eventually.
So here we go.
I think this is satisfying for kids and stuff. And, you know, at least you're going to get some musical information, kind of like a Guitar Hero.
I have to play slower, but I want to play faster. That was my problem.
Yeah.
Should we take a look at the karaoke?
Sure.
Also by Smuel?
Yeah.
Here it is. So you can record yourself.
And sing with others.
And sing on the also internet. With others.
Yeah.
Or watch and play with it on the Apple TV, which is cool for parties and such. Let's see where. Should we watch someone sing or shall we?
I want to see somebody sing My Heart Will Go On. Oh, man, that would be beautiful.
Wouldn't
it's
it?
Right there. Just press play.
Oh. Magic, I see you. Oh, they didn't have their...
So you can see where she is.
Yes.
She's Canadian, of course, as all great artists are. She's getting love from all around the world, though. That's nice.
That's nice.
She's not the greatest singer, but that's fine. That's not the point, right? It's like karaoke. Karaoke. Karaoke.
Yeah, so, if you like karaoke, then you can sing with it. Here's someone, a duet.
Hey, what's up? This is Omi. I'm just right here messing around.
So they were not in the same room together, but they both recorded and you can watch them.
Don't you think that's really sweet that Omi and that little girl are going to sing together?
Darlie Short.
Wow, he's good.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's not singing now. She is on.
This is awesome.
It is pretty cool. And you can imagine how it would be even better on the TV. Not really, cause I think that I found
myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need you. I could, and that's by the way, the other side of this. You can watch other people doing
right.
it. And I could sit and watch that all day. I think that's fantastic. How exciting for both of those people. Unifying the world.
Mm-hmm.
I love that
idea. So that's Smuel.
That is that one is on the Apple TV. I don't know what the Apple TV interface is like, though. We'll have to take a look
know.
At that.
I don't know. We will take a look. Because, it showed up last week when I was when we were doing that.
Yeah, it's one of the first apps on Apple TV, just as Smuel. I think it was an Ocarina. I'm thinking it was an Ocarina. It was the first app one of the first apps I ever used on the iPad.
So, there's GarageBand, of course.
We should mention Rocksmith, not available on iOS, but that is, and thank you, Marsworm, for reminding me, that is the, and you can do that on a Mac, a PC, and it is the app that teaches, it's kind of like Guitar Hero, but you can use real instruments and teach you how to play, really, in the same kind of game environment. I wish that had been around when I was a kid, because I think I might have gotten farther in the guitar if I had more fun doing it.
Yeah.
You know, all I remember is blisters on my fingers.
Right. The piano apps, I think, would be fun instead
Same
of just
thing.
Practicing
yeah.
all the time
yeah.
on the piano. But, you know, you actually need the instrument. I think you're right that it is better to use.
Well, I was disappointed. You know, my son has always had guitars. He loves playing the guitar. And then I get to his house. He doesn't have any guitars. He has Guitar Hero guitars, the little plastic guitars.
What happened to the guitars he had?
Sold them for crack, I guess. I don't know.
All right. Those are the music apps. That's what I've got.
That's what we got, and I think that's pretty inspiring.
Yeah.
You should definitely look at the Smuel stuff for fun, but I think Musician really would teach you how to play guitar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And, yeah, Musician, try the free version. I think for the entire year it is $100, but you can unlock just certain
parts. You know what? You know how much real guitar lessons with a human being would be?
A lot.
That's very expensive.
Yeah.
There's a lot more. We'd love to hear from you if you have some suggestions or tips or picks for us. How could they get a hold of us, Megan Maroney?
They can email us at iostoday at twit.tv, or you can call us 757-504-iPad. We also have a Reddit community, so that's reddit.com/r/iostoday. You can comment on there. Or I'm on Twitter at Megan Maroney. Lots of tips there.
Say again?
At Megan Maroney on Twitter.
Oh, okay. I thought you said Megan Maroney Oleski on Twitter.
No, I said I get lots of tips there.
Oh, okay. I was just channeling. Because that was your maiden name.
That was my maiden name.
But Twitter wasn't around before you were married.
No,
so.
Nope. I've always been
always been
Megan
the Maroney.
Maroney.
All right. Our show today brought to you by Gazelle. If you are looking to get a new iPhone, a new iPad, you should sell your old one at Gazelle. There's no reason to save it, throw it in a drawer. It's like throwing money away, or at least throwing it in a drawer. Except it is kind of like throwing money away, because I can guarantee you one thing, that old gadget's not gaining in value. Every day it gets to be less and less valuable. So don't waste any time. Go right now to gazelle.com and see where it says sell smart. Click that blue button and start entering in all your gadgets, iPhones, iPads, tablets from Samsung and Microsoft. They'll pay you top dollar for this stuff. They'll send you a check, a PayPal credit, or for a little extra, an Amazon gift card. They'll bump that up 5%. Look at that, $285 for your 6 Plus. See, now you can afford to go to the 6S, right?
Mm-hmm.
I have to say, Gazelle is a great way to get a great quote. And that quote is guaranteed for 30 days. Even if you don't use Gazelle, you know, the quote gives you some valuable information. What is that old device worth? Now, here's another nice tip. The best stuff they get, they also will sell. So click the Buy Smart button if you need to replace a broken iPhone or a Samsung phone or broken iPad. Maybe your kids lost the iPad. You get great prices on gently used, pre-owned stuff. Everything Gazelle sells has been put through their rigorous 30-step, inspection, so that they make sure everything works, that there's no big scratches on the screen or anything. So you know it's in good shape. And, of course, you have a 30-day return policy. So everything is sold without a contract, so you don't have to worry about increasing your 2-year contract. But they do work, all the phones, with AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile, and Sprint. They have devices for all 4 carriers. I think this is a great way to replace a broken phone or get a phone for your kid. Save some money. Gazelle. To buy or sell, it's got to be Gazelle. I just made that up right there.
So, yeah, good idea to sell your iPad now, because guess what? You can order tomorrow night.
Now, we don't know yet. First of all, it's finally official, because Apple put out a press release today.
Mm-hmm.
Up to now, we've been saying it's a rumor, but the rumor turned out to be correct. November 11th, 11/11. They didn't say when, though. Is it like, we don't know, you go online, I have to get up at midnight again.
Mm-hmm.
Traditionally, that's when you do it, at least this high-demand products like the iPhone. You know, the store will open shortly after midnight. I say shortly because it varies. But shortly after midnight, you can go online, and in this case, you'll be... They say pre-ordering, but if it's going to be in stores on Friday, I figure you're pre-ordering for delivery, like, end of the week or next week, right?
Mm-hmm.
We don't know. I will get up at midnight because you need one. And, you know, I was convinced last week that I need one.
Right, and Lisa needs one.
And Lisa needs one. My wife needs one.
Probably
and we'll
10
all
or
12 need
people
pencils.
People in the audience need one too.
I bet you need one, and you. I think that's an important thing. I don't think everybody needs an iPad Pro. First of all, it's very expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Do not get the 16-gigabyte model. That's really designed for two reasons. One, so Apple can quote a low price point, $799. But also, there are businesses where you don't need the extra 128 gigs of memory because it's going to be just running one specific thing. You're really gonna want to get the full one. What is it? $1,079 for a cell phone based model, Wi-Fi plus cellular, 128 gigs. I probably will not get the LTE, so that means $950. Then you have to choose your color. There's the traditional 3 colors. No Bros Gold though, just silver, gold, and space gray.
Good thing you're getting 3. You can get all.
I get one in each.
Yes,
but it's expensive. And I have a feeling that really it's not going to, you know, for instance, it doesn't have Force Touch. It has 4 speakers, so that's going to be interesting. It's really designed for, a limited number of professional apps, things like GarageBand and other music mixing apps, or things like the design programs. Paper just released 53 Designs, what's the name of it?
Yeah, 53
just released the newest version of Paper, which has a bigger drawing space to take advantage of the 12.9 inches on the iPad Pro. Those apps, if you use those apps, this is going to be, I think, a very desirable product. But I don't think just a bigger iPad is going to be better for reading the news or playing the games. And it is so expensive.
What about just for work?
Well, it depends what your work is. I mean, remember... You can buy a keyboard, but I don't think this is a laptop replacement just yet.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like this is a new category that I'm very bullish on, but it remains to be seen whether it's going to be do all the things you want it to do. Yes, I will work on it, pages and numbers and
Well, Tim Cook says he travels only with his iPad Pro and his iPhone.
He's the CEO of Apple. Do you think he might have a dog in this hunt?
Well, yeah. Would he just make that? He couldn't make that up. Someone could.
Sure,
just
he could.
It.
No. What else does he travel with? An entourage, a retinue, a cook, a maid? It doesn't mean it's you. It means it's Tim Cook.
Well, I think a lot of my work is very similar to Tim Cook. So that's what
actually, it is kind of the CEO iPad. I think that's probably true. A lot of times what CEOs want is, the CEO's not typing his own or her own letters.
Right.
But they need a dashboard with information about how the business is doing, and they need to be able to review documents, maybe Skype, that kind of thing. It should be good for that. You know what? We don't know yet. We will certainly have one. I think by next iOS today, we'll probably have ours. And we'll do a full review at that point. But I would, my counsel would be, unless you know, then there are people who go, oh, I'm getting that no matter what. Mm-hmm. Ben Thompson from Stratechery, who does little hand-drawn graphs and stuff illustrating his articles. He can't wait because he uses a paper, and he wants to do it on a bigger, with the pencil. The pencil's going to be cool. I don't think it's going to improve his artwork. He's pretty bad, but he wants it.
So it's not going to turn me into an artist, is what you're saying.
That's my biggest problem, I'll be honest with you, is I want to do all that stuff, but I'm as good an artist as I am a guitar player. So it's not going to be, I probably am not going to be able to take advantage of any of this stuff. And I don't know how useful it'll be, you know, in this context. You know, I do like the idea you could do multiple windows. I think that's going to be, it's unknown. This is early days yet. Can you wait 1 week and start to read the reviews? Maybe go play with one at the Apple Store before you spend $1,000. That's
or
a lot of money.
Watch next week.
I think next week. And I'm going to be brutal with this because I am not the natural audience for this, right? So I'm going to be brutal. My sense is it's probably not for, you know, if it's for you or not.
Right. So speaking of new products, last week I talked about the new Microsoft Band 2. A couple people.
Are you liking that still?
I still like it. Now
you're
I'm wearing both. I'm wearing both on there. And I still really do like it. I had some updates. First of all, I said this briefly, but one of the complaints I had was that I had to turn it on every time I wanted to see the time.
Have you figured that out?
Yes. By the end of the show, I mentioned it briefly because...
Paul Thurrott said he thought that there was a way
mode.
To...
Watch mode.
But then it turns off everything else. In other words, watch mode is a watch mode.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't, you're going to lose some of the other things that it does.
Oh, so yeah, watch mode, you can have it on all the time. What I did is activate on wrist raise, I do with the Apple Watch.
Good.
So yeah, I don't have it on watch mode, but it is nice to have a watch mode that you can turn it into, which the Apple Watch does not have. You can never have it always on.
My biggest complaint about the Apple Watch is this, the black screen of death.
Yes. So what I also mentioned was you can't text... you can't respond to text messages or emails when you pair it with an iPhone. If you're going to pair it with a Windows phone, you can do a lot more stuff. Yeah, you can talk to Cortana and all that. But for now, with an iPhone, it is a little bit limited in terms of, I wouldn't just wear this and not wear the Apple Watch.
But as you said last week, you had just started using it. You were going to give a first look. At this point, I'm getting a ticket right now. At this point, do you still like it?
Here's how I use it. I use it all day. I use it when I exercise. And then in the evening, I charge it before I go to bed. And then I wear it at night, and it tracks my sleep. And I like that. And I have, this is the first day I've worn both of them. Because there was a lot of
things that I missed.
It does. It looks like the double tour kind of thing, doesn't it?
Of course it is. It's a double tour. In a geeky kind of way.
I like it. Now there's the Mi Band that just came out today. It's only $15. That's one's going to go here.
You should just go all the way up.
And then the next one, and it's just going to be, I'm going to be like Iron Man wearable.
It's like Wonder Woman. You could clash your bracelets.
But it does, the Apple Watch also doesn't include GPS, so if you want to use GPS when you're running, you can't, you have to bring your phone. So I don't have to bring my phone with this.
As is the case with a lot of stuff now, including the iPad. You know, somebody's asking in the chat room, well, should I get a Surface Pro or an iPad Pro? It's really getting hard because everybody's coming up with some very interesting products, but there are differences, and it's getting hard to figure out which one's right.
Yeah, you're going to have to make some compromises or wear them both, as I do.
Or listen to Megan.
So another product I wanted to talk about really quickly that you made fun of was the Loopy. This case that I've been using for a week.
I mocked it.
You did, but I really like it. This was a Kickstarter, and it's not. If you want one, you can order them now.
For those of you listening at home, it's a kind of traditional shell case with one distinction. It has a rubber loop sticking out of the back.
So
that's the loopy part.
And it's sticky. for it's grippy. So you can grip
Sticky
it.
Sticky or grippy?
Grippy. Okay. Grippy. So I really like it. It's really nice to, you know, it's nice in the hand. I put it on wrong, but it's still
So the idea, I'm still trying to get my head around this. People keep throwing these things, these things at us. Every year since the iPad came out, I've received another case that has a grip in the back. And I can understand with the iPad, because the iPad's too big for you to hold in the palm of your hand. But you just feel like this, it makes it more secure in your hand.
Well, because my hand, maybe it's the shape of my hand, because my hand doesn't reach all around, so it's...
I've been meaning to talk to you about that.
So I really like it.
Well, that's because you have a 6S Plus. You have a
big phone. Yeah, this is a 6S Plus, so yeah. I don't know if you'd need it. But if you order it now, it'll come in January, so don't think about it as a gift.
Oh, so you have an advance.
This was a Kickstarter. They sent it to us to review.
Right. Loopy.
And I do like it. It comes in different colors.
Yeah.
Loopy.
Loopy.
You know... IFTTT.
Do I know it?
Yes.
I'm the number one proponent of if this, then that.
Well, here's a new deal. I know that you're a digital subscriber to the New York Times,
as am I.
But if you're not, and you get annoyed by having to not, you know, to see all the ads, and you're an if this, then that proponent.
I am. Yes.
This month, if you add one New York Times recipe to your if this then that, you get 6 months free.
Of?
8 weeks free.
The New York Times?
8 weeks free of the New York Times digital subscription. So.
Wow. All you have to do is add one recipe?
Just one. Mm-hmm.
Oh, you don't mean it like Mark Bittman's cooking recipe. You mean an if this then that recipe.
Right, like I added a recipe that said every time there was a movie added to the critics, then they would email me. So that I could be reminded.
You know what, I'm
going to
do that.
The New York Times critics.
Even though I already subscribe, there are some good recipes in there. They must have just added the New York Times to if this then that.
Probably, it's a promo.
Yeah.
You can save new and popular technology articles to your Insta paper.
Roll your weekly Sunday morning edition.
Do you use it on a regular basis?
If this and that? Yeah. For instance, when I'm getting a ticket.
Are you really getting a ticket?
Yeah, it's too late now. I just saw the meter maid go by. No? They moved my car already? All right, thank you. I have a bad habit of parking up front, and you only get 2 hours. And so, fortunately, we have a very nice team that somebody
moves
will take my keys. And I have a deal with them, because I have a nice car. If they want to drive it around the block a few times, they can do that and then park.
Like Ferris Bueller's Day Off, kind of? That's what they do.
Oh, God. No, what was I about to say? Oh, if this and that. I have a recipe, for instance, when I pull up out front. You know, I have one of those automatic OBD2 devices you plug into the port on your car, and it measures all sorts of things. And among other things, it knows when you turn the car on and or off. And so what this does is if I turn off the ignition in this area, it does an if this then that that posts a tweet saying Leo has just pulled up, everybody put down your drinks. And so that's kind of cool. That's with the automatic. I have if this then that with Hue lights, for instance, when the sun when the sun goes down, because you can tell when sunset is, I had my Hue lights slowly come up, right? The lights go on. Mm-hmm. And then I forgot I made that recipe, and I could never figure out why my lights kept turning on. And then finally, like 3 months later, I went, oh, I set up that recipe. So a good idea to keep, just check every once in a while to see what if this then that's doing, because it keeps doing, it's a robot. It keeps doing it forever.
Yeah, it doesn't know when you're
I have all sorts of things. When I make a trip in my car, it will save the details of the trip, how far I went, where I went, how much gas I used, things like that. All of this coming from that little device. It'll save that in my Evernote. So I have an Evernote notebook full of all my trips that I'll never look at. It's all sorts of stuff like that.
So Internet of Things, as long as we're talking about that, another one of our sponsors, the automated home. Time to talk about Ring.
Oh, I thought you were calling me a ding-dong.
No.
This is it, the Ring video doorbell. Another thing I love. So the idea is your doorbell could do much more than just go ding-dong. What if your doorbell could not only ring the chimes in your house, but ring your chimes wherever you are? I can, on my Apple Watch, when somebody's at my door ringing the doorbell, my Apple Watch says, somebody's at your door, and then I could pull up my my iPad or my iPhone. I can see who's at the door. Ring is amazing. See this It has a wide-angle camera on it. Let me just open this up. It has a wide-angle camera on it. It also has a speaker and a microphone, so you can press a button, even if you're not at home. When, like here, I'm at work. I could say, yeah, what is it? I can hear them. I could talk to them. It also has a motion detector, which means I can also tell, even if somebody doesn't ring my doorbell, if they're lurking around my house. That's super, super handy, because it turns out burglars pretty much always strike during the day. And the first thing they do is ring the doorbell to see if you're home. And then if you're not, they go around back and break in. About 95% of home robberies actually occur while you're at work. Ring makes that impossible. And even if somebody does do that, you've got video of them at your door. I mean, somebody's at my door here. I could just check. This is, so it's wide angle. So you could see, I think that's Lisa leaving. Yeah, she's probably yelling at Michael. Oh, she's talking to the dog. She's getting the dog in. This is right before we came to work, I think. So this is awesome. I mean, you can see what's going on. You can hear it, as you can tell. You can set the motion detector to how sensitive it is. I've just got it so just at the driveway, but you can set it out to the street if you want and get video of people pull up. I love this thing. This is my Ring video doorbell. Now, it's easy to install. You don't have to be a handyman. I'm not. I'm about as good a handyman as I am a guitarist and an artist. But the point is, most wired doorbells are simple to remove, just two screws. There'll be two wires coming out of your door. And then they give you everything you need to install it. There we go. There's the shot. Including a drill bit, if you need to drill in, the screwdriver bit. And it's got a special bit. This is the proprietary Ring bit on the back. That keeps people from just unscrewing your doorbell. There's the screwdriver handle. It comes with all the screws you need. Look at this. You get a level, so you install it nicely. I really did. I was proud of myself. And you might wonder, well, why is there a USB cord? Well, that's kind of cool, too, because the Ring video doorbell does not require a wired doorbell. You can put it anywhere. It has a lithium-ion battery that's good for a year. You charge it up here. So once a year, you take it off, charge it up, put it back on. It's very easy to pull off. This is what is screwed into the wall, the panel on the back. And that means you could put this anywhere. You could put it in an apartment, even if you don't have a wired doorbell. You could put it on your bedroom door. I've often thought of doing that. The Ring video doorbell. Get free shipping right now just because you're watching the show. Isn't that a nice ring, too? All you have to do is go to ring.com/iOS today, and we'll FedEx it right to you. So if you just can't wait, go to ring.com/iOS today. And I want you to use that URL because that's a signal. That's like a little doorbell ring to Ring saying, hey, I saw it on iOS today.
Yeah.
I really like making it. Ring.com/iOS
yes,
today.
We wouldn't be here if it weren't for sponsors.
For Ring?
Ring. For sponsors.
Oh,
all of the sponsors,
right.
Including Ring.
Right. No.
So now we also wouldn't be here without you asking us questions, making comments, correcting us when we're wrong. We have an email from Neil. We talked about this a little bit earlier. In your iOS Today episode 270, you mentioned several times that you cannot play Amazon Video and Google Videos on the new Apple TV.
Well, okay, I understand what they're saying. I'm saying there isn't an app for it.
Right, he says this isn't correct.
That is correct. There is no app on the Apple TV. You can AirPlay it, and you can AirPlay anything that you can do on your iPad to it. I don't consider that an adequate solution. The quality's not as good. There's issues with
that. It's just a pain
to do that. It's a pain.
This is about ease.
What I'm saying is there needs to be an app, right? And it's clear to me that neither Amazon nor Google wants to support Apple TV. But I would say to them, Amazon, Google, it's not Apple you're supporting by making those apps. It's us. It's your users who want to buy movies in the Amazon store, who want to buy movies in the Google Play store, and we want to play them on our Apple TV. The people you're really disadvantaging are your customers. Knock it off. Amazon pretends to be a customer-centric company. Your competition with Apple is not helping your customers. Stop it. Enough said.
Amen.
And yes, you can
AirPlay
it.
Sing it, brother.
But I don't think that that's what we're looking for.
All right, we also have a voicemail from Laura to play.
Megan, my name is Laura. I'm calling from Arizona. I have a question for you. I'm going to be doing a cross-country move from Arizona to Indiana in about a month. And I will be by myself and pulling a trailer. And I was wondering if you had any ideas on apps that would give me guidance on that trip, maybe places to stop, where to pull over, where not to pull over, those kinds of general safety questions that someone who is single and moving cross country might need to know. Appreciate your help and love the show. Thank you very much.
What a great, great question.
So I have a few answers. Last week on Tech News Tonight, I interviewed Selena Larson, who's a tech reporter, a young woman, and she traveled abroad by herself. And she said that she used most often Foursquare and TripAdvisor, which is something she doesn't use regularly on trips. But that when I looked into it, they do not only, they won't just recommend places to stay, but they will tell you how, what the area around it is like, whether it's safe if you're alone, whether it's safe if you're a woman. So, I mean, we've talked about Foursquare a lot, but there's a lot of on-the-ground kind of knowledge.
That's great. And I would hope that women, and I guess guys too, would share that information when they give tips on Foursquare. You know, both of those apps are general apps. They're not specifically about traveling safely alone. But if you give a tip on TripAdvisor or you give a tip on Foursquare and you have something to say about that, that's great. Add that to your review for sure.
Yeah. The other thing I would say is just scheduling like a regular check-in with someone at home or someone that, you know, just say, wow, like, I'm going to check in with you once a day. I mean, you have your phone, so you do have a little bit of or your iPad or both, a little bit of safety. But just before you start, just set up, you know, how I'm going to check in with you once a day. And if you don't hear from me, then do something about it. So that's what I would.
There is a standard for notifying people if you're in trouble, right? And I would recommend this for your phone or others. I'm trying to find, there's one is emergency, which you, in fact, there was one that I recommended to my daughter that's for college kids where, and I'm trying to remember the name of it, where you let people know that you're walking home, for instance, to the dorm, and your friends can keep an eye on you, they could see where you are, they could check in with you, and if something untoward happens, you have an emergency button that will call them or let them know. I think this is a really, really good idea. This is called Emergency, S-E-E. It's not the one I was thinking of, but the same idea. If you get in trouble, you can use your smartphone to notify people. Maybe the chat room remembers the name of this app.
Recently, yeah, I remember. I feel like it was, did you say iFollow? Or no?
Maybe it is. It's for college, women specifically, but really college kids in general. And it's a great idea. I sent a link to my daughter, and I wish I could find the name of the app, because I said, you really should install this, and you should tell your friends to install it, and they should all use it, so that when you're walking home at night from class, that people know where you are and what you're doing, and they can kind of remotely keep up on you. And I'm just wondering.
Gardner recommends Find My Friends, which is
Find My Friends. Apple's Find My Friends does something similar.
Someone that you're gonna contact.
Yeah.
Someone else in the chat room had swung by too fast, but recommended an app called iExit, which isn't the exact same thing.
iExit's kind of cool because it tells you what each exit, as you're driving down the road, what's available: restaurants, hotels, rest stops, what you need. I think that's a great idea. iExit is a great app. Let me see if I can find this walking home dorm. I don't know what to type into the search. I wish Apple's search app search was better. Maybe I should just Google it. Apple. Walking home dorm safety. That seems like those would be good terms, right? Now, remember, I know that our emailer is not just asking specifically about, this is it, virtually walk you home late. Here it is. Let's see if I can, if it'll have the link. This is from Cosmopolitan. This app can help a friend virtually walk you home late at night. What a great idea it is. It's called Companion.
Companion.
Companion. And the idea, well, this might be the easiest thing, is just to show this. So you plug in your destination. Your companions, who are your roommates or your boyfriend or your friends or your girlfriend, they don't even need to have the app. They'll just be kept in touch. You'll share your location. And then there's a big button that says, are you okay? And it will connect to a dispatcher in a couple of taps. I think that's a really good app. I wanted my daughter to install this. She said, you know, I would love to use this, but no one I know will use it with me. And I think that's a shame because I think that's.
I'll use it with Abby.
Yeah. I said I'd use it with you, but I'm, you know, too far away to really be of much use.
That's true. You have to be close by.
So, yeah, you really want your roommates to use it. I think Companion could conceivably be used as you travel across the country as well. This is, you know what, this is a great question. And it's one of the reasons you want to have diversity. Okay, I'm going to go on another rant here. Mm-hmm. One of the reasons you want to have diversity in the tech industry. If it's just a bunch of young men, they're not going to think of apps mm-hmm. like that. The more women you have making apps, the more likely. I think the fact that there's a dearth of these apps shows you that this is an underserved population. I think this would be a very good thing. Somebody should get to work on this right away. And if we had a little more diversity, I'm afraid this would be less of an issue. I think Companion is iPhone only, which makes sense. It's free. It's called Companion. Never walk alone. Let me just.
And TSSFZ in the chat room is recommending Waze also, which has that feature too. If you share your location, even if that's good for your cross-country trip. You know,
if you're traveling cross-country and you don't have Waze, get it.
And then, yeah, share your location with someone.
In fact, what I would say, you're going to have Apple Maps if you're iOS. You probably have Google Maps. Almost everybody does. Get Waze because that is not as attractive a mapping application. We'll reroute you. If there's traffic, it's just a great app to have and has that additional feature of you can say, I'm on my way, and people can then follow you. Glimpse used to do that. I think they went out of business, alas. No?
Yeah, use it.
Glimpse is still around? Okay. It was the other one that went out of business. There were two of them. Glimpse survived. Glympse. That's another great app. And then finally, get the Nokia Here maps. They sold that recently. But those are really useful because you can download the map the whole United States, if you want, ahead of time. So even if you're in and this is the biggest risk, you get in an area where your cell phone doesn't work. Mm-hmm. So you can't make a call. All of those apps that we just described need internet access. At least with Here Maps, you'll have the map, and you'll know where you are, and you can plot your way out of that area. That would be the biggest worry, is what happens when you don't have cell coverage.
Right.
So you don't have internet, you don't have phone service. And all the apps we just mentioned are really going to be requiring that. Life 360 is another one, life360.com.
And Waze just got an update. It's less cluttered than it used to be. I know you said
it did. It's prettier than it was.
But it's still a little
cluttered. Unattractive. Doesn't matter. It's so useful. I don't care.
Yeah. So we talked about animated GIFs. We also talked about animated GIFs. I like to use both.
Which do you have a preference?
Interchangeably.
Interchangeably as well.
Yeah. And Dev from LA sent us a few, which I think we might.
That's good.
Yeah, that's good.
I like the tongue action on that.
Mm-hmm, that is.
I look. Oh dear.
It's just the visor.
Oh,
it was
dear.
Perfect.
Oh
what
dear.
What should
oh,
we
dear.
Do with these? Do we need to do like a new advertising kit or something that we could use? Or just have them playing during the show, maybe? Thank you, Dev.
You know, there's a feature in the chat app that I like the best, which, by the way, this could easily fit into. Telegram, I've told you about mm-hmm. this before. But there's a feature they've added now where you can, if you're not sure what image you want to send, you can search for an image. You can even search for animated GIFs. So you just give it the keyword. And if you want to look, I don't know, if you're searching for Doofus Says What, then we got it.
That it should be Twit Says What.
Twit Says What.
So as I don't know if we mentioned that there's an Apple TV update. Did we mention that yet?
9.01 is out. And of course, Apple says nothing about what it fixes. Have you had this problem? Because I've had it now on two Apple TVs where you'll be watching something. The new Fargo TV show. Mm-hmm. You got to watch that. I'm watching Fargo. Really exciting moment. And then the TV goes black.
No.
It goes and goes black. And then it comes back like a second later. It's not my TV. It doesn't happen with any other set-top box. I checked the cables, and at first I thought, well, it must just be this unit, but it's happened to me now on two different Apple TV units. I'm hoping that this 901 fixes that.
And is it while you're watching something you've bought, or it doesn't matter?
In this case, it was watching iTunes and a TV show I bought. I think it happens on Netflix, too, though.
Huh.
Yeah, it's a very strange... Yeah. It's a glitch.
No, we've done a lot of Crossy Road.
Have you?
My boys play a lot of Asphalt, some game
Asphalt 8.
Asphalt 8. They play a lot together. and we watch a lot of Netflix, HBO Go.
And no, it's never went
anywhere.
Never gone.
Nope. Not yet.
Okay. And I think YouTube. It's maybe I just have a bad unit or two.
Maybe.
It's not buffering. It's something different. It's a weird. Apple TV handles buffering well, although that's another issue I have with Apple TV. Have you had this happen? You buy a show and it says, okay, we'll be ready to watch this in 14 minutes. And then it goes, 3 minutes. No, two, no, one, 5 minutes. No, 7 minutes. No, 12 minutes. No, 1 minute. Have you had that happen?
I haven't, no, but that
I get a lot of bandwidth, and it's hardwired Ethernet, so it's getting all the bandwidth.
Interesting. No, and mine's not hardwired because my Ethernet is way across right. The other side of the room, so it's just doing on the Wi-Fi.
Lisa says, put it on the Wi-Fi. I said, it's not going to get better. This is the best possible signal. It's Ethernet right into the router. You can't get better than that.
How do you survive?
Right. She's probably right. She put it on Wi-Fi.
I got a tweet from Two Cows who says, we might want to mention this. It's an almost hidden section in the games section of the App Store.
Anti-freemium.
Pay now. Pay once. And play.
We did mention it when they first started doing it, and I thought it was really brilliant. And you're absolutely right, 2Cows Games. I'm thinking 2Cows Games has one of those games. Lumino, the one that you picked as your game of the week last week, is pay once.
And play.
Yeah,
play
I think everyone. This is great. And this is Apple saying, you know, come on, guys. Mm-hmm. You know, free is not free if you have to buy $300 worth of donuts.
That's true. All right, I got one more question from Ron from Farmington Hills. He writes, my 8-year-old daughter discovered Vine while staying at a friend's house.
Oh, dear.
Fortunately, it didn't result in discovering the myriad of inappropriate content on Vine. Is there an iOS app that allows you to make videos in the same manner as Vine, but without the online content that comes with it? My daughter really just wants to be able to make her own vines.
Stay tuned. My app cap will help you do exactly that.
Right. Well, there is the Vine for kids, but that's just for watching, not creating.
Right.
So I know if anyone says
that,
we've showed that before.
I want to encourage people. I love it that he's saying my daughter wants to make these videos.
Right.
I'm going to encourage that. I'll show you a great app for 8-year-olds. Great app for 8-year-olds.
Okay. Yeah, yours is a little more advanced. But for more simple ones like Boomerang, which we watched, that's how we made, that's why we got on the GIF conversation. Boomerang from Instagram. It's not as long as a Vine, but it's 1 minute back and forth, right. Which is fun. We've done a lot of those. Giphy Cam is another one that I think we've talked about on the show.
I think you also could just say to your daughter, please only follow these age-appropriate people. Watch who she follows. Because she won't see anything that isn't from people she follows. Or will she? Maybe Vine has a popular thing that shows up. This is the most popular Vine. I'm trying.
But
to
she
remember.
Wants to mostly create them. She doesn't.
She can use Vine to create without looking at any.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You're gonna like what I have for you.
Okay. So
this is better because the truth is Vine is so limited because it has to be how many? What is 8 seconds?
Eight,
10 seconds?
9 seconds.
Has to be so short. That's become a part of the art form when you make Vine videos. And there's some amazing Vine creators. Some of the animated stuff is just amazing. But why limit your daughter? Why not? We'll show her something that will let her make an 8-second video, but also can make a 2-hour video.
Turn her into a regular
Spielberg.
Yes. So that is all of the questions and comments that I have. You can write to us at iostoday@twit.tv. You can write just to me, Megan at twit.tv. Or you can write to Leo, but he might not.
I won't pay any attention. I won't respect you.
He will respect you, but he probably won't reply. Better to.
I try, but I get.
You do try. You get.
You know
more.
What? It's because of the radio show. A lot of people hear the Tech Guy radio show that I do, and that show is 6 hours a week devoted to just answering questions, and they think that's what I do for a living. Like that's what I want to do in my downtime is answer your question on email, and so as a result, I get a lot of emails from people who listen to the radio show. Well, Leo, I can't call in, but would you please help me with this? And as much as I have actually boilerplate, as much as I'd like to help you, I can't, or I would have no time to do anything else.
So, but I like your questions, and then I bring them here to you, because I can't
That's
answer
different.
All of them, but you
That's
can.
Different.
So
yeah.
You can call us.
No, we love those questions.
504-472-3. But also, just take your phone, record a voice memo, email it to me, megan@twit.tv. That's another way. You don't have to, you know, you can still use email. You don't have to use your phone. You don't have to make a phone call.
I'm like a doctor, you know? Poor doctors, they go to a party and everybody says, hey, doctor, can I show you this wart here? I don't know. Is that cancer? And the poor doctor's trying to enjoy his lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Not good.
Well, speaking of doctors.
Yes.
And what you like to do in doctor's offices.
What?
Read
magazines? But those are old. Those are old, and they're not magazines anybody wants. I've read every Highlights for Children for the last 25 years. I don't want to read any more Highlights for Children. Fortunately, I can bring my iPad with me, my iPhone, and I got Texture. You may remember us talking about Next Issue. Texture's from Next Issue. Think of it as kind of Netflix for magazines. You pay a low monthly fee, and you get all the magazines you could ever want. And by the way, this is better than subscribing for so many reasons. First of all, it'll save you a ton of money. But also, most magazines, I don't want to read the whole magazine. I want to read one article in Vanity Fair each month. There's one article in Wired I really needed to read, or one article in The Economist. This way, you get all the magazines. You can download them, read them on the plane. We just flew back from Colorado. Lisa had, of course, she had Texture on her iPad. She had all her magazines. She was reading, and you can dabble, you know, read a little bit of this, a little bit of that. You want to read a little less, you know, maybe I need something light. I'll read some Entertainment Weekly or People Magazine, something a little lighter. You got it all. It is the best way. And no muss, no fuss, no wasted paper, no clutter in your house. You don't have to waste time finding premium content because they have a new feature, which I love, where they pick out the best content and they update that 24 hours a day. Curated collections let you delve deeper into articles from magazines like Fortune and Fast Company and Newsweek and Rolling Stone and Wired. But if you want to read Car and Driver, if you want to read Coastal Living, Condé Nast Traveler, if you want to read all of the gossip mags, they're all there. Here's the deal. Your magazines look the same. They have the same layout, the same pages, just like you subscribe to them. You don't miss anything. In fact, you get more. Because you get features like videos that they can't put in the magazine. Visit texture.com/iOS and you'll get a 30-day free trial and then you can see for yourself. 30 days free. Get the mobile app. It's available on every device. Start building your library. Explore the many magazines at your fingertips. But do it first. Do it today. Texture for free for 30 days. texture.com/iOS. We thank Texture so much, not only for their support of iOS today, but for keeping the clutter out of my house.
I have a big trunk of New Yorker magazines from
1990. I love them. Mm-hmm. I love magazines.
But I don't know what to do.
It's almost a guilt thing because you have this magazine and you don't read it and think, oh, yeah, I just want to read Talk of the Town this week. And you feel guilty. So this way you don't have to feel guilty.
Right. So we're wearing hats now because this is our app cap.
Oh, I thought it was just because we look good.
We look good in hats, yep. And we look good talking about our favorite apps of the week.
You're a lieutenant,
I
right?
am. Yeah, these are in honor of Veterans Day, which is Wednesday.
And I am a chief petty officer.
Chief of the Love Boat.
Of the Love Boat. this is, yes.
Captain of the Love Boat.
Just call me Captain Steubing. No, this is a Coast Guard hat, right? It's not Navy. I think it's Coast Guard, yeah. A Coastie brought it by one day. He was a chief petty officer. He said, you can have my hat.
Well, we thank all our veterans.
We do. Thank you for your service.
Yes.
That is a huge sacrifice, a huge commitment. We really appreciate it.
So my app for the week is Google Keep, which is not new, but it was newly updated. Google.
I love this app. It is fairly new. For a long time, it was just on Android.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I used it on Android when I used to be on Android, and I loved it for lists and gift ideas and to-dos and everything. Now they have the iOS app, and they also allow you to immediately port your lists to Google Docs. So we do a lot of our work on Google Docs. So here's some topics
I have in
mind. And if I want to keep them on a Google Doc, I'm thinking this will be good also when I get the iPad Pro because that's what I use for work.
Right.
Can use Google Keep. And I just click on those little three dots. I can do all these things. One is copy to Google
Lisa Docs. And I use it for our grocery list. Mm-hmm. And I like it because I can use it on Android and on iOS. And when I add something to the list, you see here's our Petaluma Market list. One thing that's nice is you can tie it to Petaluma Market. Mm-hmm. So when you're nearby, when you're nearby, you can say, here's your list. And so she can add to that, and I will have it. It also shows up on your Apple Watch. In fact, it shows up as a list on your Apple Watch, which you can check off, really great.
That is nice. Especially good for the holidays when everyone's saying, I want this. And you can take pictures. You can add photos just like this. Take a photo, or I can... Let's take a photo.
You can add drawings now. That's one of the new features. You can add images.
I'm going to take a photo of you to remind me something.
The man I hate more than any other.
No.
Yes.
I'm going to remind, I'm going to use my list.
The man who's going to buy me a new iPad Pro trying to get on my good side. Captain Steubing.
iPad Pro.
That's cool.
So Google Keep, it's free. I really like it.
Yeah. Yeah. And by the way, you can also see it on the web, so you don't have to have your iPad or your iPhone
right
around.
So yeah, so you don't have, yeah, it, you can have it on the web, you can have it on your phone, on your iPad, on your watch, all the places. Google Keep. You know, I'm a big fan of Wunderlist, but
Wunderlist.
I don't know.
By
Google
the Wunder
Keep
kids.
Has a few more I features. Know. Also Wunderlist was just purchased. Yeah. By Microsoft, so
and,
I don't know. If
same thing with Evernote. I used Evernote for years, yeah. And now I'm thinking Google Keep. Google Keep. It's a good choice.
Do you have any privacy issues with the Google Keep?
Yeah, Google knows what I'm going to buy at the grocery store. I don't care. No, I don't have any privacy issues with Google.
Okay.
Google knows everything about me, and I'm glad. I want them to. I want them to.
Okay, good to know.
I have nothing to hide here.
So now...
So we were looking, we were going to mention that we have a great app. Speaking of Google, now this just got sold to Google. It's the Fly Video Editor. But here's the good news. Google just made all the in-app purchases for the Fly Video Editor free. So I'm thinking this is a great time to pick this up. It is a unique... By the way, these are some of the additional things. The Clips Video Editor... The Tempo Video Editor, Crop on the Fly. Let me get that one. These used to cost money. This used to be in-app purchases. Now you just install them and then you add them and they're part of Fly. Oops, let's just do my Touch ID there. Here's a few of the settings. Auto save to the camera roll. That's a great idea because what you're going to do is you're going to make videos. So let's go in here. Actually, what I'd love to do, and I guess I can't do it, is rerun the demo because my editing, not so great. I made a little video, but I don't know if it's the...
In a world where the boots are made for walking and the Segways are made for riding.
Not the best video ever.
Also, we don't know what happens in that world, which
that
I mean,
world is not finished.
What happens in the world.
So here's how it works. you can make a video. The best thing to do, by the way, is not look at me, but to watch the demo when you first download it. We ran through to the beginning of the show, so I've already... Dude, first thing, I got to admire them. They say, please, don't shoot vertical video, okay?
But they will crop it for you.
They will crop it if you've already shot it. So let me shoot a little bit more video. First, I'm going to have to take this out of here. If I can, I'll pry it out of here. And I'm going to shoot some video.
Sound or just no sound?
Do sound, and I can decide later.
Happy Veterans Day, everyone.
That's good. It does say take a little bit longer, but that's okay. They want you to take longer. I take a picture, too. Let's change the brightness and the exposure, and it's a nice little, it's a simple camera. This is, again, remember, this is to replace Vine for your 8-year-old. It, I think, is easier to use than Vine because look at the editing capabilities of this. I'm just going to have to hold it by hand. That's the video I just shot.
Happy Veterans Day, everyone.
That's good.
Now, I can combine it. Let's say I want to transition from that to that by swiping over. Let's rewind here. Whoops. Rewind. By swiping over, I can create a dissolve into that. I can add other videos. Let's find some videos that I've already shot here. Let's see. That was a cute one. And maybe this one of Lauren Hawkinson. I got to get her name right. And I'll just put some more videos in there. All right. Preview these. Let's see. Okay, that's probably not the best picture of Lauren. And she's just going to... How about... There you go. Okay, that's good. I'm going to import both of those into it. Unlike a lot of other programs, including iMovie, the editing is very simple. You really just swap these in as you want them. In fact, you can actually run through this and add transitions to it. Once you've got it the way you want it, maybe you want to add a little bit of music. You'll take music from anywhere in your iTunes library. That's something you can't do in Vine. So I really like this. Let's put a little Led Zeppelin behind here. I think that's going to sound pretty darn good. I have some other things I can do, like turn the level down on some of these so we don't have to hear you say anything. I picked the music. Let's see. Okay, we're going to import All of My Love. And I can even add narration after the fact. Very simple video editing that is easy to share. So if, you know, she wants to be a Vine, a Viner, you can share this to Vine, but also Facebook messages, Instagram, WhatsApp. Instagram might be a better place for your 8-year-old. Mm-hmm. You know, that's probably a good place for her to share her videos too. I think this is really just an awesome program, very easy to use. And now's a good time because Google just bought them. Now, admittedly, that may mean they're going out of business. I don't think so. I think Google's going to keep them around. But what I do love is that Google is giving away all of the tools. And the nice thing is, even if Google shuts this down, if you've downloaded the app, you have it. You have all the tools. You can continue to use it. It doesn't require any servers or anything else. So Google's not going to put them out of business. I really like this. I had never heard of it until I read the news that Google bought them. And now I'm thinking this is a great little product. I can actually see why Google bought it. It's called the Fly, F-L-Y, Video Editor. Play with it a little bit. I think you'll be very impressed with all the things it can do. And what's nice is for an 8-year-old, it's very simple. Vine, the appeal of Vine is that you just press record. But it's also the limitation of Vine.
Mm-hmm,
it's very hard to edit. It's got to be short. You can't make changes very easily. I mean, there's some advantages to that. And, you know, you could totally use this the same way. Record, and assemble. But you can do more. And as she gets more sophisticated and she says, you know, I'd like to see it dissolve here. Or you can have picture in picture. You can have two videos in the same frame. There's a lot of really cool stuff you can do. F-L-Y, my app cap, the tip of the hat, tip of the chief's hat to Fly. Congratulations on being sold to Google.
And that's it for our show. That's all we got today. Hopefully next week we'll have our
All we got?
That's a lot.
Maybe
a lot,
this will expand to a giant.
Let's
13-incher.
Hope so. Yes.
It'll be fun. I can't wait. I'm excited, actually. You talked me into it. I'm glad you did.
I'm glad I did, too.
Thank you, Megan Maroney.
Yeah, thank you, Leo Laporte.
And we'll see you next time
on iOS Today.